Welcome everyone, Happy New Year to you. I hope you've had a safe and peaceful and happy Christmas. And here we are in 2021. So welcome to St. Nicholas Church where this is being filmed. Some notices, they will be sent out to you via email, but for those of you that don't get email and for those of you that want to know now, we have a Christianity Explored course due to start on Monday night, Monday the 4th of January at 8 p.m. If you know anyone who'd like to learn about the Christian faith and what it means to be a Christian, please tell them about the course. Encourage them to do that. And if you want information, please speak to Jeff Ellison, and he will be able to give you more information on that. The other thing to say is that on Tuesday night, our Bible study is going to begin, and it's a fortnightly Bible study at 8 o'clock at night. And this time we're doing it on Jonah. That will be on Zoom. Can I really ask everyone to think about New Year, New Year's resolution? Let's try a Bible study. Let's see what we can learn, how we can learn more about the Bible and what is contained in it, what we've got to learn about. So New Year's resolution, sign up for a Bible study. The other thing to let you know is the Christingle service. At the moment, the church is, we're not holding services face-to-face with people. The Christingle is set for the 31st of January. It's still going to go ahead. I don't know whether we'll be in the building, whether it'll be outside, whether it'll all be online, but put the date on your calendar, the 31st of January. If you normally take a Christingle tube and save in it prior to the Christingle service, if you have a tube at home, please do so. And if you haven't got a tube at home, make one. Put some money aside for our Christingles for the Children's Society, which, like all charities, needs as much giving as possible at the moment. So something to have on the diary, the Christingle service. And finally, looking even further ahead, wow, we are really being proactive here. We're thinking about Easter. So if any of you are into knitting, I need you to come forward with your needles. We have got a knitting pattern of an Easter chick, which works out about this sort of big. Please, 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 if you can knit and would like to knit some Easter chicks, we've got all sorts of people that we're going to be giving them to at Easter. I'd love to hear from you. I have a pattern. Please get in contact with me and I can give you that pattern. So, things immediate, things a little bit further off, and things a long way off. How exciting is that? We're now going to sing our first hymn. I bring you good news of great joy. A Saviour has been born to you. Alleluia. Unto us a child is born. Unto us a son is given. Alleluia. He is Christ the Lord. Alleluia. We worship and adore him. Alleluia. Glory to Christ, Son of Mary, born of a child. You are one with us. Glory to God in the highest. Glory to Christ, Son of David, born to rule. You reign in our hearts. Glory to God in the highest. Glory to Christ, Son of Man, born to save. You are the light of the world. Glory to God in the highest. Amen. And now we say sorry. Christ, the light of the world, has come to dispel the darkness of our hearts. In his light, let us examine ourselves and confess our sins. God, our Father, you sent your Son, full of grace and truth. Forgive our failure to receive him. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Jesus, our Saviour, you were born in poverty and laid in a manger. Forgive our greed and rejection of your ways. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Spirit of love, your servant Mary responded joyfully to your call. Forgive the hardness of our hearts. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. May the God of all healing and forgiveness draw you to himself, that you may behold the glory of his Son, the Word made flesh, and be cleansed from all your sins, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And the Collect for Epiphany. God our Father, in love you sent your Son that the world may have life. Lead us to seek him among the outcast and find him in those in need. For Jesus Christ's sake. Amen.
For thus says the Lord, sing aloud with gladness for Jacob, and raise shouts for the chief of the nations. Proclaim, give praise, and say, save, O Lord, your people, the remnant of Israel. See, I am going to bring them from the land of the north and gather them from the farthest parts of the earth. Among them the blind, the lame, those with children, those in labour together. A great company they shall return here. With weeping they shall come, and with consolations I will lead them back. I will let them walk by the brooks of water in a straight path in which they shall not stumble. For I have become the father to Israel, and Ephraim is my firstborn. Hear the word of the Lord, O nations, and declare it in the coastlands far away. Say, he who has scattered Israel will gather him, and will keep him as a shepherd a flock. For Lord has ransomed Jacob and has redeemed him from the hands too strong for him. They shall come and sing aloud on the height of Zion, and they shall be radiant over the goodness of the Lord, over the grain, the wine, and the oil, and over the young of the flock and the herd. Their life shall become like a watered garden, and they shall never languish again. Then shall the young women rejoice in the dance, and the young men and the old shall be merry. I will turn their mourning into joy and will comfort them and give them gladness for sorrow. I will give the priests their fill of the fatness, and my people shall be satisfied with my bounty, says the Lord.
Sleeping, whom angels angels greet with anthems sweet, while shepherds watch our keeping. This is Christ the King, whom shepherds guard while angels sing. Haste, haste to praise him there, the babe, the Son of Mary. Why lies he in such mean estate, where ox and ass are feeding? Good Christians, fearful sinners, hear the silent word is leading. Nails, nails shall pierce him through, the cross he'll bear for me and you. Hail, hail, the Word made flesh, the babe, the Son of Mary. So bring him incense cold and myrrh, come peasant king to own him. The King of Kings salvation brings, let loving hearts enthrone him. Raise, raise the song on high, the virgin sings her lullaby. Joy, joy, for Christ is born, the babe, the Son of Mary.
Hear the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem asking, "Where is the child who has been born King of the Jews? For we observed his star at its rising and have come to pay him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all Jerusalem with him. And calling together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. And they told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it has been written by the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel.'" Then Herod secretly called for the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring me word, so that I may also go and pay him homage." When they had heard the king, they set out, and there ahead of them went the star that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then opening their treasure chests, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they left for their own country by another road. This is the Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. So may I speak in the name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. 2021, a new year, a time to give thanks to God for all that we have in our lives, our families, our homes, our belongings, all the things we have. But above all of that, we have Jesus, who we welcomed at Christmas, who came to offer us all life eternal with him through his death and resurrection. You could say, nothing has changed from 2020 yet. We're still in tier 4 and we're not able to meet as a church family or with our own family and friends. And you would be right. We are like the Israelites in our reading from Jeremiah. It feels like we are and have been in exile. But in the reading we heard, God says, see, I am going to gather them, a great company. They shall return here. It doesn't say when, but God, through the voice of Jeremiah, is preparing the people. They are to take heart, to have faith that God has not abandoned them. God is preparing new things for them. And Jeremiah says, with weeping they shall come, and with consolations. I will lead them back. I will let them walk by brooks of water, in a straight path in which they shall not stumble. And I know some of us are lamenting and grieving at this time. Others of us are in very difficult positions of uncertainty. And what we hear there in Jeremiah is echoed in Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I lack nothing. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. He refreshes my soul. He guides me along the right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. And I want to assure everyone, whatever our circumstances, that each and every day, God is with you through the Holy Spirit. We are individually changed, transformed by the Holy Spirit. We are filled and refreshed by God's love and grace to continue our own journey of faith to Jesus through the ups and downs and twists and turns of life. Looking at the year ahead, I've been reflecting a lot on Isaiah chapter 43. On New Year's Eve, some of us gathered on Zoom and said prayers in relation to this and the church and ourselves and our families. And I'm going to read you part of Isaiah 43. And when I do this with my hand, I want you to say your name out loud. Okay? So when I do that, you say your name out loud. Isaiah 43. But now, this is what the Lord says. He who created you, he who formed you, do not fear, for I have redeemed you. I have summoned you by name, and you are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you. And when you pass through the rivers, they will not sweep over you. When you walk through the fire, you will not be burned. The flames will not set you ablaze. Forget the former things. Do not dwell on the past. See, I am doing a new thing. Now it springs up. Do you not perceive it? I am making a way in the wilderness and streams in the wasteland. The wild animals honour me, the jackals and the owls, because I provide water in the wilderness and streams in the wasteland to give drink to my people, my chosen, the people whom I formed for myself, that they may proclaim my praise. If you have any thoughts or anything that comes to mind on these verses, please email them to me. We have come a long way during 2020, and it has been a time of learning new ways of worshipping via social media. And you're all watching now either on Facebook or on YouTube. Who would have thought that at the beginning of 2020? In the coming year, we are moving on to Zoom. Each week, a link will be emailed out to you, and you can then click on that link and join the service. Now, don't worry, it's okay. These services are also going to be linked to Facebook and to YouTube so that you can watch them in your normal way if you can't access Zoom. And this is going to happen from next Sunday, the 10th. Today is Epiphany, and we heard about the kings, the wise men or the magi, travelling from afar to find the king of the Jews. An epiphany means a moment of sudden and great revelation or realisation. Some of us think of it as a light bulb moment, a eureka moment, when everything becomes clear. The wise men saw Jesus and knew in that moment that here was the saviour of the world. We don't know their nationality, but we know they were not Israelites. Yet God chose to reveal them to his son. A sign that all people are welcome to come to Jesus and to turn to him as Lord of all. And today, I'm going to baptise a husband and wife, Connor and Charlie, at St Paul's Church. They're going to give their lives to Jesus as Lord and Saviour. It's a symbol that the church isn't closed. There is new life. New life. New brothers and sisters in Christ. Jeremiah and Isaiah spoke of praising God at all times and in all places. And this is the time to praise God for Charlie and Connor's declaration of faith. Please keep them in your prayers. And traditionally, Epiphany is a time of physically blessing our homes, our families, and our lives. It involves using chalk. And if you haven't got chalk at home, perhaps you could use a pencil or something non-permanent. And I'm going to be putting onto the screen the instructions on what to do. And then you can either pause it and rewind it and see what you've got to do. I'll also email out all the instructions. And all you're doing is blessing your house. You're putting the year, and you're putting the cross, and you're putting the initials of the three kings. Caspar, Belchior, and Melchior. Caspar, Balthazar, and Melchior. Anyway, it's all on the instruction sheet. You'll be able to do that at home. It'd be great if when you do that, you can take a photo of it, share it on your own Facebook pages, on your Instagrams, on your whatevers. Tell your neighbours what you've done. I know when we did it last year as a family, our neighbours knocked on the door and said, "Is everything all right? There's strange writing outside your door." And we were able to share with them all what it meant, and they were amazed. sharing that blessing. So you can bless your own homes, you can tell your friends, your neighbours, and get them to bless their homes. Isn't that brilliant? And this year, we need, as 2021, we think as us growing up and becoming adults and becoming mature. Well, as individuals, 2021, the year 2021, let's be mature. Let's tell others about Jesus. Let's tell others about the church, why we normally come to church, what we believe. Let's do that. The Magi brought gifts to Jesus, and I would like you to think about the gifts that you have and what you can bring to Jesus. Financial giving is something which the church is in desperate need of, and there is never a good time to talk about that. However, at the start of the year, when most of us review things, please could you consider giving regularly by standing order. Please prayerfully consider whether you're able to increase your financial giving or what you can give at this time. I would also like you to consider how you can physically give, help the work of the church. For example, are you able to help with cleaning the church? An hour or two, maybe? And if a few people volunteer to do that, then it can become a rota and it's not a huge task. Is it that you like to sing or you can play a musical instrument? Perhaps you could join the worship band or perhaps be in the choir. Can you offer your time in another way? Could you help deliver a lunch to someone via our Eagle Meals? Can you help with making teas and coffees? We may not be able to hold clubs at the moment, but we need to be prepared. Our readings are telling us God is making a way, he's getting us ready, and we need to be ready. We need to start planning and preparing now. So please think about this, pray about it, and get in touch with me. As we begin this new year, let us be like the Magi, sharing our gifts with Jesus and the church. Let us bless our homes. We are blessed by God to be a blessing to others, not to be embarrassed or ashamed of what we believe. We have received the greatest gift of all, Jesus Christ. We who have turned to him have received new life, and we have hope through Jesus. The world needs hope at this time. May we all share the good news from today onwards. Amen. Let us declare our faith in God. We believe in God the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named. We believe in God the Son, who lives in our hearts through faith and fills us with his love. We believe in God the Holy Spirit, who strengthens us with power from on high. We believe in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
This is the first Sunday in the new year, 2021, and I found myself drawn to the passage from 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 17. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, the new creation has come. The old has gone, the new is here. Many of us will be pleased to see the back of 2020 and look forward to the hope that comes with a new year. There have been lots of prayers and good wishes on social media, and I would like to share a few of them with you now. I have been given permission to use these prayers. A prayer by Kerry, who used to worship at St Paul's, a nurse who is now living in Suffolk. Happy New Year seems an odd thing to say this year, but it is nonetheless true that I do pray, not just for my family and friends, but also for a world that has seen so much pain this year, that things will be better as we move into 2021. We have seen extraordinary acts of love and kindness, and the tireless efforts of amazing colleagues in the NHS who have gone over and above what could be expected of them. There are many caring for our elderly and those in need or disadvantaged. Every one of those acts of kindness and sacrifice are precious. May the Lord bless you and keep you and all those you love in 2021. Happy New Year. From a prayer by Jean. May this year be a time not to look back and to accuse, blame and discourage, but to look forward and encourage, work together, achieve, move on and be thankful. Like many, I mourn those I have lost, but give thanks for friends, family, and yes, I trust in the one who will one day fulfil the promise that the message of Christmas brought. So Happy New Year. And now, the Church of England prayer for NHS and care workers. You can join in if you wish. Faithful Lord, you make your home among the vulnerable. Hear us as we pray for all in the NHS and in social care, who tend to the needs of others. As they continue their works of mercy, may they know your protection and the peace that you give. In Jesus Christ our Lord. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayers. We pray for the Queen, who, like so many, is isolated from her family. Let us take inspiration from her New Year's message. We shall take comfort that while we may have more still to endure, better days will return. We will be with our friends again. We will be with our families again. We will meet again. Heavenly Father, we pray for continued health for Her Majesty and for Prince Philip. We pray too for Prince Charles and Camilla, and for all those members of the royal family who work tirelessly for the community and the people of this country. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, we pray for all the politicians as they endeavour to come to grips with the ever-changing situation with COVID. We pray that the rollout of the various vaccinations will be done as speedily and effectively as possible, that the country will soon be able to return to some semblance of normality. Heavenly Father, we pray for this country now that we are no longer in the European Union. May the changeover be as smooth as possible and be to the benefit of this country's citizens. We pray too for the United States as they prepare for a change of leadership. We pray that Joe Biden will hear your voice and act for the best for America and for the world. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, we pray for all those involved with education. We pray for the Little Doves children and families and for Pam and her team as they plan for the future. We pray for Mrs. Putt and the teaching staff at St. Paul's School and for the school in Kelvedon Hatch. May the decisions made regarding going back to school and the proposed testing be the best that can be made and that the testing will be effective. We pray too for the senior schools and for all those whose exams have been disrupted. Lord, be with all those young people who will be returning to university or who will be studying online. Lord, it all seems so chaotic at present, and we pray that certainty will prevail. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, we pray for those known to us who are sick in mind or body, and for those who mourn the loss of dear ones. We pray for continued healing for Joe, and we pray for Terry and Jar. Thank you that we are able to share our prayer needs via social media and other networks, that although isolated from one another physically, we are linked spiritually and are able to support one another. The pandemic has heightened our sense of frailty, both physically and mentally, and we pray that we can draw strength by becoming closer to the Lord Jesus. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, we pray for Julie and her family as she grapples with all the constant changes of what we can and cannot do. Thank you, Lord, for her enthusiasm and the positive way she has brought church to us, albeit virtually. Lord, we long for the day when we can once again come together to worship in our church buildings. But in the meantime, help us all to be lights shining in the darkness, where the smallest kindnesses can reflect you to others. Heavenly Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
The Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Thank you.
Father, today we see your Son and we worship him. We see the reflection of your glory, the imprint of your very being. Creator of the heavens and founder of the earth, we wonder at this child sent to be our salvation. Amen. We come now to the blessing. May the Father, who has loved the eternal Son from before the foundation of the world, shed that love upon you, his children. Amen. May Christ, who by his incarnation gathered into one things earthly and heavenly, fill you with joy and peace. Amen. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be yours this day and always. Amen. My brothers and sisters, our act of worship is finished. Our act of service is just begun.
Christmas Day, a humble girl gives birth to hope for all the world. This is Emmanuel. How awesome and mysterious, the Lord of heaven draws near to us. This is Christ. Emmanuel.